What it do, YouTube? It's your boy, Snank815, and I'm back with another video. Y'all new to this channel, man, make sure you hit that like, subscribe, share, comment, get notified when I drop these videos. Today is a reaction video to me. A reaction video to Cat Williams talking about Oprah and Tyler Perry. Let's get into it.
Trending lately for all the wrong reasons, and now Cat Williams is joining the conversation and exposing Oprah and her buddy Tyler Perry for being Hollywood snakes.
On the deep end of it, they have an idea that there's a messiah coming and they're not sure who it's gonna be. They just know it should stick out, so they look every time something sticks out to make sure that's not it.
The rumors about Oprah's shady and evil side are getting louder by the day, and it all started after Monique recently revealed that she's still waiting for Oprah to apologize for killing her career.
I would say, Oprah Winfrey, you know what you need to do, and stop hiding behind what you call was negative comments, what you call, oh, I don't even deal with things like that, because what people are beginning to do is see you for who you are.
And not just that, recently reports emerged that Oprah and her close friend Tyler Perry have been pushing an agenda to emasculate and humiliate black male actors.
In the black community, you see that there's a systemic issue with black men being emasculated on screen in order to be more palatable to the white audience.
And this is just the tip of the iceberg, because there's also been a lot of talk about Oprah's very close connection to Hollywood elites and handlers who not only control the entertainment industry, but also famous celebs. But if there's one celeb who is never afraid to speak out against these elites, it's Cat Williams. So what exactly did Cat say about Oprah and Tyler Perry?
We have to see this guy be right enough times that we go, wait a minute, he can't be crazy and right.
Yeah. There's been a very loud conversation going on social media about the shady side of Oprah Winfrey and Tyler Perry. And fans are saying that these two need to be knocked off that pedestal they've been sitting on for years. The talk about Oprah being an evil narcissist have been around for years. And
if you can't see it, Platinum Plus.
Monique recently revealed she's still waiting on Oprah to apologize for killing her career. Fans started digging for dirt and discovered a ton of problematic things Oprah has done over the years and how she got away with it with the help of powerful Hollywood people. Now, in case you're not familiar with Monique's feud with Oprah, the drama started back in 2009 when Monique refused to go on a press tour for the movie Precious. Precious was co-produced by Oprah and Tyler Perry, and these two wanted to send Monique on a press tour ahead of the Oscars to take advantage of the hype surrounding Monique's nomination. However, they refused to pay Monique for the tour. And since Monique was already exhausted from doing such a challenging role in Precious, she told Oprah she'd rather spend downtime with her husband and kids. Now, at first, Oprah didn't say anything, and Monique felt like they were cool. Just weeks later, the tabloids started pushing stories about how Monique is a difficult person and impossible to work with. Despite Monique winning the Oscar for Precious, no one wanted to hire her, and all the offers she received were taken off the table. Now, at that point, Monique realized that her career was being sabotaged, and in her recent interview with The Hollywood Reporter, she revealed that Precious director Lee Daniels admitted that she was blackballed. Monique also told The Hollywood Reporter that she still demands and expects public apologies from Oprah and Tyler Perry. And if you think that Monique is blowing this out of proportion, keep in mind that the drama surrounding her press tour wasn't the only shady thing that Oprah did to her. In fact, this seems pretty tame compared to how Oprah exploited Monique's SA trauma. Between the ages of 7 and 11, Monique was SA'd by her older brother Gerald. And just months after, Monique refused Oprah and Tyler Perry's demand for a press tour. Oprah invited Gerald on her show to talk about what he did to Monique.
I did assault and inappropriately touch my sister in manners that were not comfortable for her. For that, I apologize.
Now, to be clear, Monique's SA wasn't a secret. She had already opened up about it in her 2008 interview with Essence Magazine. However, what was secret is Monique's difficult relationship with her parents, who previously dismissed her SA. And Oprah knew all about this because Monique told her in confidence about her relationship with her mom while she was preparing for her role in Precious. So imagine Monique's shock when she discovered that Oprah invited both of her parents to talk about her SA alongside Gerald without telling her. This was a very petty boo.
Now I begin to see commercials with my brother, my mother, my father, and my other brother. Now the reason why that means so much is because in the conversation we had about my brother, we then went deeper. And we began to talk about our relationships with our mothers and our fathers. And I shared my relationship with her about my mother. I shared with her that me and my mother was not talking. I shared with her we were in a really bad place. I shared with her I was hurt. And, you know, trying to this thing out. She never said my mother was coming on that show. Because had Oprah Winfrey said, I'm going to have your mother, I would have said, shut it down.
Monique explained that when Oprah called her, she only mentioned Gerald and wanted to talk her into joining him. However, Oprah never mentioned she would invite the rest of Monique's family.
Because she said, do you want to come on? I said, I don't want nothing to do with that cat. I said, the nigga I know is up to a scam. But people can change. And who am I to say he hasn't changed? It might really be different. So I don't want to get in the way of that. I just don't want nothing to do with it. She said, if you don't want me to have your brother on the show, I will cancel the show.
But Monique isn't the only person whose trauma Oprah exploited on her show. Oprah has a long history of faking friendships with celebs to get private information and then using that info to boost her ratings. A number of celebs have called Oprah out for being a snake, including 50 Cent, who once said that Oprah is an Oreo, black on the outside, but white on the inside. 50 made these comments after Oprah dragged him over his explicit lyrics and claimed that rappers like him perpetuate hateful behavior. That's when 50 fired back, saying that Oprah started out with black women's views, but has been catering to middle-aged white American women for so long that she's become one herself. Ludacris is another rapper who called out Oprah over her shady behavior after she invited him to her show only to humiliate him in front of everyone. In 2005, Oprah invited Ludacris and the cast of the crime drama Crash to her show, but instead of talking about the movie, Oprah used the opportunity to attack Ludacris over his use of the N-word in his songs.
There was a lot of certain comments that she had made about, you know, I was there for a Crash, for the movie.
Yeah.
And basically she said something about not agreeing with my music, but she thought I did great in the movie. And of course I was up there with the whole cast of Crash.
Mm-hmm.
And so I didn't necessarily feel like that needed to be said. You know, you didn't agree with my music. And even if you don't agree with certain songs I made, say you don't agree with certain songs, I'll say you just don't agree with all of my music.
Right, right.
But what's the worst part is that Ludacris actually gave an intelligent response to Oprah's accusations. However, when the episode aired, Ludacris realized that Oprah cut out all of his responses.
I mean, she was able to say what she said, and then I had my rebuttal. And when I saw the final show, her comments were in there.
Representative Jones wasn't in there.
And mine weren't in there, so it just looked like I kind of took it.
And speaking of humiliating black men for ratings, we can't forget Oprah's close buddy, Tyler Perry, who's faced numerous allegations of promoting an image of emasculated black men in his movies. Actor and voice coach Verandon Jay recently went viral on TikTok after posting a video exposing Tyler Perry for pressuring him into playing a gay character. Brandon was cast in Perry's sitcom Meet the Browns in the role of Jock, a high school teenager dealing with bullies. However, according to Brandon, Tyler decided to make a last-minute change to the script and told him that his character would be gay and have a crush on his high school bully instead.
So in the middle of Mr. Perry changing up the scenes, he says, you know, I want Jeffrey to be gay. And he has a crush on his bully. That's not what I auditioned for.
Now, when it comes to Tyler Perry's orientation, rumors about him being on the DL have been swirling for years, and fans have accused Tyler of projecting his own suppressed feelings on other male actors. Also, Tyler Perry's portrayal of female characters is highly controversial, and he's been accused of perpetuating harmful stereotypes about black women. Director Spike Lee previously criticized Tyler's movies and called them coonery buffoonery. And all you need to know about Tyler Perry's character is summed up in his response to Spike Lee.
That is my answer to Spike Lee. Go to hell, go.
Basically, Oprah and Tyler Perry have faced criticism for acting like they're pro-black, but at the same time perpetuating stereotypes about black people to appeal to the white gays. And we've yet to see either one of them show some humility and accept criticism with grace. And this is exactly why multiple black celebs have distanced themselves from Oprah and Tyler Perry, including Cat Williams, who once explained in an interview that the media will often paint people as crazy when they speak out against Hollywood snakes and their hypocrisy.
In order to technically be sane, it requires that your belief system go along with everybody else's. And so that's why they put such a high modicum on labeling you as that, just in preparation for what you might later say.
Mm-hmm. And though Kat didn't name any names, we all know that Oprah is an expert at trying to make people look crazy when they decide to go against the system that she upholds. She did it to Monique, and she also did it to Dave Chappelle in 2006. Oprah invited Dave to her show to talk about why he turned down a lucrative deal from Comedy Central and fled to Africa. But instead of acknowledging Dave's experience, Oprah kept making condescending comments, and at one point, she even tried to get Dave to admit that he had lost his mind.
Was he
say you lost your mind, sort of?
No.
So what happened? Did you find yourself spiraling? Was there a tipping point for you? People were saying, though, that you were on drugs, you lost your mind, you went into a mental institution.
I don't want black people to be disappointed in me for putting that out there.
But you didn't want to be disappointed in yourself.
Now, as for Cat Williams, he never appeared on the Oprah Winfrey Show. And looking at how Oprah treated Dane, we can understand why. And when it comes to Tyler, Cat has always been very vocal about why he would never trust him.
I don't have any hatred in my heart for Tyler Perry because he works hard.
About how the media and Hollywood elites are trying to emasculate black men, this is what he said.
At the end of the day, Kevin doesn't have to worry about what people are going to say about him wearing a dress because of the long line of dress-wearing people before him. So now we have Big Mama's House 1, 2, and 3.
Yeah.
I've never seen Madea in a pantsuit. Some of us are against the Illuminati, and we are against the Illuminati at our own detriment. When people are against the Illuminati, then they get punched in the face all the time. The press hates them. Nobody likes them. And Dave Chappelle has never been a part of the Illuminati. They don't want him or me or people like us.
Fans are now saying it's high time Oprah and Tyler Perry are held accountable for all the shady things they've done, and they're hoping that the day will come when these two get canceled. One fan said about Oprah, "I've always known she was some kind of evil. Nobody gets that wealthy off one TV show, whether they own their own network or not. She was the perfect channel to pump agendas and thought patterns." And another fan added, "Bullies like Tyler and Oprah are finally being called out for their dark